In this video, you will learn three strategies which will help you to market your Amazon product better, and it will make you more customers by implementing these strategies before and after your customers purchase your products. This event is part of the Seller Fest online virtual event, which is sponsored by two companies, VA Academy and Getida. Getida is an FBA auditing company. They help in maximizing FBA reimbursements for Amazon sellers of any size, big or small. So contact them, check their link below. And also VA Academy is helping Amazon sellers with virtual assistants. And they can help you at any area, PPC, management, listing optimization, product research. Check them out and you will find the link below in the description. In this session, we'll have two guests from Post Purchase Pro, a company which helps with email marketing, Amazon and e-commerce sellers. And I will be hosting the session together with Lisette. Hi, Lisette.
Hi, Augustus. Happy to be back here with you to host another great session for Amazon sellers. And I'm also very excited to welcome our two guests who will share undervalued Amazon product marketing strategies. So hi, Shawn, and hello, Seth.
Hi.
Hello. Thank you for having us, Augustus and Lisette. Really looking forward to helping your community here and sharing some amazing strategies.
Well, thank you for joining us. And actually, before we go to your today's presentation, could you first introduce yourself a little bit and tell us what you do in Amazon space?
Seth?
Yeah, sure. So, Lisette, we partnered a long time ago, back in 2014, and we started building brands. We ended up creating 53 brands ourselves, launching more than 1,000 private label products, and we ended up selling a lot of those businesses. In 2020, we took everything that we learned, and we started our current company, which is Post Purchase Pro, which helps Amazon sellers make a lot more money by making each one of their customers more valuable by following up with them and creating more sales. Shawn?
Yes, thank you. Great. So my name is Shawn Hart, the other co-founder of Post Purchase Pro. We live, sleep, eat, and breathe customer relations, list building, customer nurturing, and follow-up funnels. It's what we do as a service. Seth and I have been able to attribute 41% of every dollar we've sold on Amazon comes from the exact service that we provide for others. So I think you're going to enjoy today's presentation. I'm holed up at a hotel here in Austin, Texas. So I apologize for the background, but I'm here to serve, guys.
Thank you very much. And while you get ready to present, I wanted to remind all of the sellers watching us live that in the end of the presentation, both of them will answer questions you have about marketing Amazon products. So make sure to leave all of your questions in the chat box. And also, if you're watching us later, then leave your question as comments.
And don't forget to like and subscribe this video at any time you like the information you hear. We just implemented like button below our video. So check this new feature. All right, yeah. Let's go.
Yeah, we are ready for you now.
Okay, perfect. So thank you and welcome to this presentation called How to Create an Insanely Profitable Business on Amazon and be able to do this faster than anyone else without being held hostage by Amazon sponsored ads or algorithm. The reason we created this strategies is because I'm sick and tired of standing back and watching Amazon sellers just like you struggle to toe the Amazon line, all while spending all your profits on sponsored ads and worse, jumping through those one-sided hoops of Amazon's terms of service. If you continue this, you'll likely never see the massive success that we've seen and that we see from other sellers that we serve all around the world who have decided to take matters into their own hands. So a real quick poll here for those of you watching live, I want you to answer the question, what do you think is the most valuable asset for any business? You can just type that into the comments box there. And if you don't mind, Lisette, you can share those with us. But do you think the product, is it your inventory, your brand name, your customers, the real estate, maybe the goodwill of your business reputation, or maybe something else? What are we seeing there in the comments?
So far we don't have, we do have a little okay. delay because it's a live stream. So it might take a while until they react to your question.
Well, we're going to come back to that. So we hear a lot of people say, well, maybe I'm the entrepreneur. I'm the most valuable asset of my business, or maybe it's the real estate or the business goodwill, but really customers are your most valuable asset. I'm going to prove that to you today. In fact, I prepared something amazing. I'm going to give you a free gift right now. It's our master customer care templates. You don't have to opt in. No email or phone number required. Just simply scan this QR code or go to ppro.co/customer care and you can download the template. It looks just like this. This comes from our friend, Greg Reynolds, from Zon Support. And basically, you can have this simple copy and paste solution to use for handling most of Amazon customer email requests. This is yours free to use as a thank you for joining us with Orange Click today and the Seller Fest Online. Amazing. So again, ppro.co or scan the QR code there. So today I'm going to show you how I sold an additional $62,730,000 on Amazon in three simple steps. And here's my promise. I promise I'm going to show you why everything you thought you knew about growing your Amazon business is wrong and how you should be leveraging Amazon to create a wildly profitable and valuable business instead of just fulfilling orders. So Seth and I have identified three core misbeliefs in our industry. Unfortunately, a lot of sellers think that the best way to make more money is to attract new customers to your Amazon listings. Or maybe you're thinking that customers who are already shopping on Amazon, browsing and searching for products, are the best source of new traffic that you have. Or maybe you are spending more money on sponsored ads and keyword rankings so that you can create more sales. I'm going to show you why this is wrong. So if you believe just one or all three of these misbeliefs that we've identified, then today's presentation will turn your entire seller world upside down and you'll begin a new journey toward amazing Amazon success, armed with new knowledge that will leave your competitors astonished at your rapid climb to the top of the e-commerce food chain. Here's the reality. The reality is that the best way to make more money online and more profit is to sell your existing customers more products. And the best source of traffic is actually your customer's email and text list, your customer list, right? Because Amazon, I'll show you, rewards external traffic with better keyword ranking for your listings. And finally, I want you to only use sponsored ads to attract new customers into your business, not so that you can transact, but so that you can sell to them again and again and never, ever, ever be hooked on using sponsored ads as a way to grow sales. Because if you do, then your profits are going to continue spiraling downward. Now, once you understand why all this is wrong, it will completely change the way you view your business and you'll finally be able to unlock massive profitability. And you'll finally understand how the most successful Amazon sellers in the world are operating their business. So here are three goals that I have for you today. Number one, I want you to see that the only way to grow to insane success on Amazon is to take control of your customer's journey. And to realize, I want you to realize that the longer you put this stuff off, the more at risk your business will be for collapse. And finally, I want you to know, I mean, really know exactly what you need to do to instantly take control. And instead of playing in Amazon's card game, instead you're dealing the cards and you have a handful of aces when you start. So 41% of our revenue, like I said, comes from the three simple steps that I'm going to be sharing shortly. And this number I found to be true across the board for the most successful sellers that we've seen around the world. Now I know 41% sounds like a little, right? It's like 41 cents. It may sound like not so much, but remember that accounts for over $62 million for our business. And when I finish today, you're going to know exactly how you too can grab those extra millions in profits that you've been leaving behind every day. These profits are being taken by other sellers who are competing with you, right? And the extra profits that we're talking about won't take you any more work on your behalf. And the longer you wait to fix this, the more it's going to cost you. It's urgent that you get started right away if you see something that makes sense. Let me show you how. All right. So are you ready to stop losing to your competitors, take control, make millions more? Here's what most sellers do, unfortunately. Most sellers, you create a transaction on Amazon, you pocket the money, and then what? And then you go out looking for new customers, right? Using sponsored ads or the latest ranking hack. Well, you forgot about the most profitable part of your company, your business, and that is the customer. Here's what your business should look like. You make a sale on Amazon, and then you follow up maybe with an email, and you can make another sale, additional sale, and then you follow up with a text message, maybe make additional sales, and then other channels as well, continue to make additional sales. Well, everything that happens within this bracket after the initial purchase is what we call post-purchase marketing. All right. Post-purchase marketing. Why is this better? Because your customers, yes, your Amazon customers, are the most likely people in the world to buy from you again, whether the same product or other products in your brand line. When you can sell to the same customer again, you don't have to pay for advertising, so you're not wasting your profit on sponsored ads. By sending your customers back to your Amazon listings, this also triggers the strongest signal to Amazon's algorithm to rank your products higher for those search terms. And because this traffic is coming from an external source, and you'll soon understand what I mean by that. So when you get this, it completely changes the game of building businesses on Amazon. So you want to see how we applied this concept to Amazon? What if all of your customers on Amazon purchased from you more than one time? Would that really make a big difference? I bet it would. In fact, it's an even bigger difference than you can imagine. Why is this so powerful for Amazon sellers? Because your profitability goes through the roof, because when you create these additional sales, you're not paying any marketing costs like PPC. So every extra order that you generate is always at your maximum profitability. And Amazon rewards these listings that attract high quality external traffic with higher keyword ranking. So recently, I had a call with a very high ranking employee at Amazon who admits to me openly, right, that high quality external traffic is preferred by Amazon and it's rewarded by Amazon's algorithm. So I actually had the phone call with and I said, look, what we're seeing is we're seeing sending my customers back to Amazon, even if they don't convert to a sale, gets higher ranking. And he says, listen, Shawn, it's way higher on the A9 algorithm because Amazon's algorithm weights it out. Especially if the traffic's coming from a clean URL, Amazon gives you an outweighted score. And they also measure the previous benefit from that particular traffic source to Amazon as a company. So he says to me, Shawn, your assumptions are absolutely correct. You are not reading tea leaves. You're reading binary truths that this traffic does get a higher weight. So he confirmed my assumptions, said all this. And I said, listen, I can't prove it. And he says, well, I could have proven it to you, but here's the case. If you send traffic from a clean URL, it's shown to be high quality, then Amazon's rewarding you. Now, listen, Amazon is admitting this publicly. You don't have to have a recorded voice change conversation anymore. Amazon's featuring what's called Amazon Ads Partner Spotlight webinars that are designed to help you and I as sellers learn how to maximize our business with trusted partner services. I have a clip here that comes from a recent webinar where AJ from Amazon.com sits down with our friends over at amped.io to discuss the use of outside traffic that's sent through brand referral bonus links. And basically, AJ says, Lumino as a company saw that their rankings climbed as more customers were considering their brands for their needs, and it also proved effective in overcoming the cold start, so accelerating the ramp up of new ASINs that they introduced to the customers. So now they're admitting it, right? Now that's going to be important in just a moment. So let's take a look at the three simple secrets. And secret number one, I'm going to show you how you can compel your Amazon customers to engage with your business at the point of purchase with what I call an attention-getting marketing device. Then secret number two, I'm going to show you how to collect and manage your customers' contact information using a strategic funnel with a valuable mafia offer. More on that in a moment. And then finally, in secret three, I'm going to explain to you how you can follow up with your customers post-purchase with a world-class, what we call monetization marketing sequence that offers customer service, enhances the user's experience, and then also includes offers to buy more from you. What will this do for your business and brand? You're going to create an extremely valuable list of your customers. You can build a profitable relationship that generates repeat orders on demand. This allows you to drive much more profitable sales, create more natural reviews, push your search term rankings up the page, and make a lot more money. In fact, it's really just good business practices that 94% of sellers are not even thinking about. What I'm talking about here is no secret. I didn't invent this stuff. It's happening every day in bricks and mortar stores and shops up and down Main Street. All we've done is take this age-old concept of nurturing a relationship with a customer, and we've applied it to Amazon. So if we're okay with Q&A and comments, let me know real quick, and I'll jump into secret one. Lizette?
Yeah. So usually we do take questions in the end of the presentation, but we did receive the first question, so we can take that right now as well. So Dominic wants to know about Amazon customer contact details. So Amazon does not release the contact details. How should I, as an Amazon seller, get the contact details for further marketing?
Okay. So great question. Let's go ahead, Dominic, and wait because Secret One's going to answer that for you. So
awesome.
I guess we'll just move forward. Thank you.
Yeah, let's go ahead.
Secret One, I'm going to show you, Dominic, how to compel your Amazon customers to engage with your business at the point of purchase with what I call an attention-getting marketing device. So remember these three core misbeliefs, that if you're believing that the best way to make more money is to attract new customers, or that customers shopping on Amazon is the best source of traffic, or that you have to spend money on sponsored ads to create keyword ranking, this is what you should be thinking about instead. When you own your own traffic, you can then create sales on demand. And think about this, your customer's first order on Amazon is only the beginning of what should be a long and mutually beneficial relationship. When you can orchestrate post-purchase marketing, that's marketing that happens after the sale, right? You no longer need to rely on buyer traffic from Amazon to create sales. You no longer need to overpay for sponsored ads. And with this, your Amazon business becomes a profitable customer acquisition channel. Hopefully that makes sense. And when you have a profitable customer acquisition channel, this allows your Amazon business to generate tons of free cash flow and profit anytime you want. When we first started on Amazon, we had a huge problem. I already knew and understood the power of a customer list, and maybe you do too. See, I knew that if I had a customer list, I could make it rain money, meaning we could produce sales on demand. We could drive keyword ranking to produce even more sales, and obviously we can increase our profits. But there's a huge problem, as you already know. Amazon also knows how valuable customer lists are, and they continue to try to prevent you and I from building our own valuable customer list. Amazon wants control because Amazon wants to own and control the most valuable asset, the customer list. Think about it. They keep blocking our access to view more and more of the customers that you are serving. They won't show you the customer's email, the mailing address, the phone number. They're trying to keep all of this information for themselves. So what can we do? Well, first of all, we have to consider terms of service. We must create a situation where your customer chooses to seek us out. All right, I slow down on purpose. If the customer reaches out to you as the brand owner, we're not breaking any rules, right? So we have to uniquely position our offer where the customer stops and says, hey, I want to learn more. And the simplest way to start building your own customer list is to include a product insert with your product. But most sellers that I talk to are totally messing this up, and I was no different. We were just like you. We would create a product insert that said, register your warranty or join my VIP club. Well, you can probably guess what happened. Hardly anyone opted into my list, but now I have a huge advantage. Seth and I have now launched over 1,000 unique private label products, and we've created hundreds of unique product inserts, and we started to see patterns of what made product inserts successful or not. Eventually, we developed a formula to create high converting product inserts, and here's what we figured out. To answer your question, Dominic, every single product serves a unique customer. Think about it. So in order to create a product insert that converts, you must first think about your customer's perspective. You must put yourself in the mind of your customer at the time of opening your package and ask yourself this question. What offer would be so compelling that my customer would drop everything that they're doing and take action on my offer right now? There are a lot of psychological triggers that you can use to boost your opt-ins, but at the core, you must have what we call a mafia offer. So a mafia offer, it's an offer that's so good that your customers will actually feel stupid saying no. So you're probably asking yourself, show me an example of a mafia offer. Well, let me ask you, join our VIP club. Is that a mafia offer? No, this is not a mafia offer. Register your warranty. This is not a mafia offer. Give 20% off on your next purchase. That's a little better, but that's not a mafia offer. Imagine this. A mafia offer speaks directly to your customer's core desires. It's not a bland or generic message that may or may not appeal to some of your customers. So let's imagine that you're selling a fat loss fitness product and you create this offer. I give you a complimentary digital membership with the top 17 workouts for fat loss, a $250 value, yours for free. I'll also throw in first-in-line access to new product launches, a 100% value, yours free. I'll even send you a free body tape measure. That's a $10 value. I'll upgrade you to lifetime priority customer service, a $200 value, and you get lifetime product replacement support, a $50 value. That, my friend, is what we call a mafia offer. When we got this right, our opt-ins went from less than 1% to over 88% in some cases. And once you create a mafia offer, you no longer have a product insert. You have what we call an attention-getting marketing device. Now, here's what we do step by step, and then we'll break down each step. Number one, you need to create an attention-getting marketing device. Second, you need to offer tremendous value for your customers to drive engagement. Never, ever ask for something that's against terms of service, like a review or a purchase offsite. You need to offer an incredible product experience by supporting the product and then give your customers a way to opt in to receive your promised value. Now, let's unpack each one of these steps individually. Step one, create an attention-getting marketing device. This very first step is where 87% of sellers are getting it wrong. Now, let's go ahead and talk about terms of service right now and get that out of the way, because there are a lot of misconceptions about product inserts. So a lot of sellers that we talk to believe that product inserts are illegal or against terms of service. Now, I'll be the first to admit that sometimes product inserts as a whole have gotten a bad name in recent history. In fact, we've all heard war stories from these seller groups about a seller account getting banned for using inserts, right? It's just not true. They're getting banned for how they're using inserts and trying to manipulate Amazon. Think about this. If you go out and buy a new pair of Nike sneakers, and on the box, Nike says, scan the QR code and you can download this Nike free run app. Is that against terms of service? No, it's not. Every single major consumer packaged goods that you can buy on Amazon and all the national household brands, they have contact information in and on the packaging. It's like a toll-free number, call for support. It's to answer questions or comments. It's emails. It's URLs. That's not against terms of service, right? If I, as a consumer, choose to reach out to you as a brand owner, we're not breaking any rules, all right? It's what you do with that contact that becomes whether you're breaking the rules or not. So what if you bought a new coffee maker and it says, go online and register your warranty? So you go to my URL and you register with name, address, phone number, email. Is that against terms of service? No, I think you see where I'm going with this. If you offer video instructions for your fat loss product, for example, so that your customers know how to use the product, get the most effective use out of it without voiding their warranty and the best results, that's not against terms of service. That's just good old fashioned customer service. That's enhancing the end user experience. So here's what we see in other sellers' products, also known as product inserts. Do not try to circumvent Amazon's ordering process. Never try to manipulate reviews. And please don't try to trick Amazon's product ranking algorithm. That's against terms of service. Step two, offer tremendous value to your customers so that you can drive engagement. This should always be about providing an excellent customer experience. And the value that you offer should be an absolute no-brainer where any reasonable Amazon shopper will want to take action. But you're going to need to come up with a value proposition that's in line with your product experience. And this is very important. I've actually seen stuff like a hammer being offered for sale, but the value proposition is a video showing you how to use a hammer. So let's just be honest. If you need to see a video on how to use a hammer, then you probably should just hire a carpenter, right? It just doesn't make sense. We like to use first-in-line access to product launches, valuable digital content, replacement programs, priority customer service, safety videos, instructional videos, complimentary bonus products, newsletters, app downloads, and things like this. You just have to offer tremendous value and enhance the end user's experience. But don't forget, the offer must be relevant to your customer. All right? So hopefully this makes sense. And then we like to use psychological triggers to boost your conversions using urgency, scarcity, value, reciprocity, social proof, and authority. All right. So we'll jump into step number three. Pardon me. Never, ever, ever ask for something that's obviously against terms of service, like an honest, unbiased review or ranking manipulation schemes, okay? If you're trying to manipulate your ranking by using some black hat hack, or you try to bribe your customers to leave an honest, unbiased review, you know who you are, right? Then you are 100% breaking terms of service, and Amazon will catch you eventually. All you have to do is give value and keep the customer's experience top priority if you want to win this. Fourth step and secret one, offer an incredible product experience by supporting your product. This is about the end user's experience. It's about demonstrating a world-class product experience. This is about building a brand through awareness and support. This is the real difference, my friend, in owning an Amazon business or owning a very valuable brand that you can exit for millions of dollars. Step five, you need to give your customers a way to opt in so that they can receive your promised value. This means that your customer must have a way to engage you to redeem the proposed value from your mafia offer. You'll use the same core principles that we use when we're creating a mafia offer to make your landing page and capture your customer's email and phone number. I'll move on to secret number two. This is how to collect and manage your customer's contact information using a strategic funnel with a valuable, what we call mafia offer. Remember these three core misbeliefs. Don't lose track of this. Don't get stuck thinking that the best way to make more money is to attract new customers and that customers who are searching on Amazon are your best source of traffic, or you're hooked on using sponsored ads to gain page rank. The reality is, now that you know, the best way to make more money and more profitable sales is to sell your existing customers more products. The reality is, the best source of traffic is your existing customers through your contact list that you can reach out through different channels. And we never want to see you get hooked on using sponsored ads as a way to grow your sales, because if you do, they're eating away at your profits. When you own your traffic, you can create sales on demand. I want you to remember that and take that away. This is going to be one of the most impactful things that you can do for your business right now. Your customer's first order is not just a transaction. You're not just ringing a cash register. You're beginning. That's like a handshake and the beginning of a long and prosperous, mutually beneficial relationship. When you can orchestrate post-purchase marketing, you no longer need to rely on new buyer traffic, sponsored ads, or any of that kind of stuff, because your business becomes a profitable customer acquisition channel. I'm going to explain in just a moment. When you have a profitable customer acquisition channel, that means that your business can generate profits anytime you like. You cannot do this type of stuff manually. You must use automation tools if you want to be successful, or better yet, just find somebody who knows how to do this stuff and get it done. Just hire them to do it for you, because 41%, it's just too much revenue to ignore. Here's what we do. The first step is your customer will follow a link, scan a QR code, or send a text message to claim your valuable mafia offer. Then your strategic funnel will capture that customer's contact information and deliver the value that you promised. Your funnel will also tag your customers in order to sort them according to purchases. Your customers will fall into the correct segments that we can use for post-purchase marketing. And then all of the value that you promised will be immediately sent through email in order to train your customers to search, open, and engage your emails. And then I'll show you why this is important, because it will spike your sender reputation so that your future messages will be delivered to their inbox instead of their junk folder. Now let's take a look at each individual task. Step one, your customer will follow a link or scan a QR code or send a text message to claim your valuable mafia offer. You have to make this simple, my friend, or the customer will not take action. Don't try to get super cute here. Just simply tell them exactly what to do and how to do it. If you keep it simple and straightforward, you'll see maximum results like this. Here's what you get. Here's how to get it. This is not going to be available forever, so go ahead and do it now before you forget. Second, your strategic funnel will capture the customer's contact information and deliver the value you promised. We like to use automations within ClickFunnels for this process. On this page, you can see this funnel page shows the simple, valuable offer, how to generate 235,013 visitors a month without spending a dollar on ads. That's the offer, right? And it also has a simple opt-in form to capture the customer's contact information. The automation inside the funnel page automatically emails or texts the value you promised through a third-party integration like MailChimp or Twilio or Aweber. There are hundreds of those. It's important to not deliver the value on the next page, meaning here's what I'm going to receive, and then I opt in, the next page delivers whatever that promise is. Don't do that. Instead, on the next page, show them that the signup was successful, include a warm welcome message and some language like this. Hey, I've just sent you a very important email that looks like this. And then you want to show a screenshot of what that email looks like in their inbox. And it includes your special free gift. Go check your email right now to claim this awesome gift. If you don't see it in your inbox, then please check your junk or spam folder, move that to your inbox, and then you'll receive our follow-up messages. It's important to click the link inside your email to claim your free gift. Thank you. Now, the reason we do this is because when you do, it shows the SMTPs, these are the mail servers out there like Gmail, that your message is trustworthy, that it's relevant, it's valuable. Why? Because the customer opened it immediately and they took action by clicking the link in the message. Where this is where we like to create what's called a slippery slope, where every interaction that we have with your customer, it's very strategic and it deliberately leads to the next action. What we do is create a situation where each step is thought out and continues them down an exact process leading to a specific goal that we have in mind for them. This unique process should always also compel your customers to fall in love with your brand like this flow. You need to create a unique and more profitable relationship both ways with each customer and along every step of your customer's journey. Now, at first, something like this looks intricate and confusing, I understand, but this step-by-step process is developed over a lot of time. It's continuously tested and it's tweaked for maximum results. Third step in secret two, your funnel will tag your customers in order to sort them according to purchases. Now listen, even though you're tempted, you cannot set this up in Gmail using your vacation auto response. These types of offers need to be tagged and tracked separately in order to ensure maximum deliverability and response. Like this. This is the backside of a ClickFunnels page under the automations tab. As soon as you opt in here, you're sent an SMS text message immediately saying, hey, you made a great decision. And then you also send an email immediately that says your bonuses are inside. Now, step four, your customers need to fall into correct segments for your post-purchase marketing. When your customers are tagged based on what they ordered, how much they spent, which offer compelled action, something like that, then you can finally speak to them in a tone and language that's congruent or makes sense for their purchase. This dramatically increases opens and engagements. Just think about it. If you buy a new Ford pickup truck and I send you information about a Chevy pickup truck, it's really not making sense, right? You have to be congruent with the purchase. The fifth step, all of your value will be immediately sent through email in order to quote unquote train your customers to search, open, and engage with your emails. Remember, do not put the value on the next page. Instead, send it in an email and then alert them that the email is there to help future delivery. Because when you do it this way, this will spike your sender reputation so that your future messages will be delivered to their inbox. Now, this little known secret is what gets us inboxed with huge open rates that drive massive sales. Here's what the process looks like. It's simple. Customer receives the product insert from their purchase. The customer visits the landing page to opt in. Your landing page delivers the value through automation. The customer lands on page two of your funnel. Page two doesn't deliver the value. Rather, page two explains that an email was sent. So the customer goes back to his inbox to collect the value by opening and clicking. And then Gmail, Hotmail, AOL, all these, they view your message as trustworthy. Now, let's jump into secret number three. This is the last one, so bear with me here. This is how to follow up with your customers post-purchase with a world-class monetization marketing sequence that offers customer service, enhances the user experience, and offers to buy more. Don't get caught up in these misbeliefs. Now that you know better, right? You don't think that the best way to make more money is new customers. You know that the customers shopping online on Amazon are not your best source. And you know that you don't have to be hooked on spending money on sponsored ads, because the best way to make more money is to sell your existing customer. And the best source of traffic is your existing customer list, and that you should only use sponsored ads to attract new customers into your funnel so that you can sell to them again and again. Don't be hooked on using sponsored ads as a way to grow sales, or your profits will continue to be eroded. Now, let me remind you the last time. If you own your traffic, you can create sales when you want, and your customer's first order on Amazon is only the beginning of something amazing. When you can create post-purchase marketing, you no longer need to rely on new buyer traffic or sponsored ads, and your Amazon business becomes a profitable customer acquisition channel. Just say that to yourself out loud. Profitable customer acquisition channel. That means you're getting paid to get new customers, and your business can generate profit whenever it wants. Let's just be honest. Every single business around the world pays for buyer traffic through billboards or TV ads or direct mail or any other type of media. There are tons of it out there. We all pay for traffic. But listen, Amazon sends you buyers each day for better than free. You make a profit from customer acquisition. You're just not seeing it that way yet. If you're making profitable sales on Amazon, then you are getting paid to create new customers. And you have new customers every day. You only need to deploy our monetization marketing to your customer list so that you can create lifetime relationships that are mutually beneficial. Here's a quick story. In 2010, 12 years ago, I discovered the value of my customer list. So I sent out a direct mail campaign and I earned $500,000 in sales. This tiny, ugly, unremarkable postcard was sent out in the mail to my customer list of 70,000. And the very first time I mailed it, it did $500,000 in sales. So I mailed it again. And what happened? I mailed this exact same postcard to my exact same customer list over and over and over throughout the year. And the results were similar every single time. We never sold less than $400,000 on one mailing. Why? Well, this is where you're getting it wrong. What you're doing is sending out a marketing message or an email and nothing happens, or you only get a little bit of action. So you quit, you give up. Your customer needs to hear from you. Your customers are not always going to be ready to purchase. Do you stop by a fast food restaurant every time you drive by? No. But does that stop them from advertising? No, it doesn't. You, my friend, have to understand this to be successful with your monetization marketing. We engage our customers again and again in order to stay top of mind. This way, when they are ready for us, we are the obvious best choice when they're ready to make a purchase. Are we being annoying? No. Do we see unsubscribes? Of course we do. But do we create more sales? How about $62,730,000 worth? You have to understand that your customer will continue to shop on Amazon well after they purchase from you, right? So it's your job to capture more of those sales by building a relationship with them. If you had a physical storefront down on Main Street, would you expect to only have one transaction with each person that walks in? Of course not. If you had a store, then you try to nurture each customer to get them to come back again and again. This is called a business. Why should your Amazon business be any different? Here's what we do. We use an amazing monetization marketing sequence to entertain and educate your customers ongoing. We then develop trust with your customers to build on that relationship. We always offer value and make soft offers to buy, purchase more products from you. We continue the same cadence until your customer opts out of your sequence, and we're able to capture up to 67% more sales to the exact same customer without ever spending a penny on paid ads. Now, let's look at each individual step and then we'll wrap this up. Step one, use an amazing monetization marketing sequence to entertain and educate your customers on several different channels. Here's the truth. Whether you like it or not, email's not dead. Email is also not just one and done. Email is a longer conversational relationship building channel. Email is one of the most profitable marketing channels in existence. And in today's hyperactive world, email stands out as a way to privately communicate with your customers, and they open and engage at a time when they choose. We like to create what we call a monetization marketing, right? Where each highly valued email delivers great content, sometimes includes an offer, but always ends with a cliffhanger that teases what's coming in the next email. It's kind of like watching a television miniseries, right? Where at the end of the episode, they're always teasing what you're going to miss if you don't tune in to the next episode. Second, develop trust with your customers so that you can build on the relationship. Always remember that your customer is a human just like you. I know they're on the other side of a computer connection, but they're human. And you need to build and nurture a relationship with him just like you would if you had a bricks and mortar store. This is where they come to know and trust your brand so that you'll become the obvious best choice when he needs to make another purchase. Your customers, you know, will continue to shop online well after they purchase your product, right? Why not earn as many of those repeat purchases or referrals as possible? Third step, we need to always offer value to your customer and make soft offers so that they can purchase more. The truth is, we all like to buy and spend money, but no one really wants to be sold, right? So if your email or text marketing only push more sales, then sure, you'll get more sales, but you'll also see unsubscribes after a few weeks. All we need to do is educate and entertain your customers with a valuable conversational emails and then add offers in each email. You can use coupon codes in your sign-offs or links to your Amazon store in the postscript section, or use buttons in your for your one-time offers in the body of your email. Don't be afraid to sell more, but just offer value first. The fourth step, we need to continue the same cadence to your customer until they opt out of your sequence. Once your customer is trained to open and engage in your messages and they're looking forward to hearing from you, the worst thing you can do is stop sending. You need to develop a cadence and stick with it. Don't sweat the unsubscribes because they will happen, all right? Just continue to send to your customers until they opt out. And what you want to do is be top of mind and be the obvious choice when they're ready to make another purchase. Now I've prepared something amazing for you, okay? So if you have a cell phone, pull it out right now, and I'm going to send you a copy of my new book called Private Label Millionaire Secrets. This is only for those of you that are joining us on SellerFest Live through our amazing friends, Augustus and Lizette, over at Orange Click. I'll give you a downloadable copy of my book. It sells on Amazon for $24.95. It's called Private Label Millionaire Secrets. I've documented the entire journey of building 53 private label brands, creating millions in profits and even more on exit payouts. So you can scan this QR code or go to the URL on the screen, pppro.co/bookfree. That's pppro.co/bookfree. And we'll mail that out to you first thing. My name is Shawn Hart. Let's bring Seth back into the studio here and we'll answer any questions you might have. Thank you so much for your time today.
Thank you very much, Shawn. And so before we move on to the questions, I wanted to mention that this session is part of SellerFest online virtual event, where we invited almost 30 Amazon experts to share their knowledge. And about 20 of them sent us additional content, additional video, which will not be publicly published. It's only available as a part of VP package, which you can explore by using the links in the description or which the link you see on the screen. And in this package, you can find those additional videos which were recorded by experts specifically for us. It's exclusive content, and you can learn. There are several videos related to Amazon advertising, how you can adjust them so that you get better ACOs and better conversions. There are some visual sessions where they explain how to improve your storefronts or how to do Amazon videos, what type of Amazon videos for the Amazon product listing are working the best. And also Shawn provided additional video. Let me find the here. Shawn, can you remind us or explain us what you shared in the additional video?
Yes, of course. Thank you for that opportunity. Yes, so we prepared three more ranking strategy videos for your folks here at SellerFest Online. And the only way to get this, as I understand, is to join the VIP group. And basically what I do is I break down our three secret strategies that Seth and I have used to build launch over 1,000 private label products. We use strategies for ranking. We use strategies for getting more natural reviews. And then we also use strategies to enhance or grow the value of your business for a massive exit. Seth, I know you have a lot of good things to say about these three strategies, and you've been so quiet.
Yeah, Shawn, you've definitely led the way here. So thank you for that. So in those three strategies, basically it's everything that we learned over the last 8 years launching all of those brands and launching all of those products. And it boils it down to the fundamentals of what we were doing differently. We didn't bring you the average strategies that everybody knows about, because that wouldn't provide any value. So what we looked for is, what are the things that we did differently to be able to scale to over $1 million a month with our own private label brands? And then we shared those with you. So Shawn, I know you spent some time really thinking through how to present that. And, yep. It's an exclusive VIP bonus here. I love it.
My favorite part about this, Augustus, is within those strategies, I share my favorite, which is called Amazon Product Launch Domination. And basically this strategy shows you how to launch a product and be successful every single time you do, without having to worry about launching a dead product, because we show you how to dig your well before you're thirsty and create a massive audience ready to jump on your product at launch. That's only available through the VIP section. Thank you so much, Augustus, for allowing us to serve your community. I hope you'll have us back on for another Seller Fest. It's been a lot of fun.
Cool. Thank you very much, Shawn and Seth. And Lisette, let's take a few questions.
Sure. Yeah, let's go ahead. And also before taking the questions, I wanted to remind once more, if you learned something new from this session, don't forget to like this video and also subscribe to our channel to see more videos like this. So a question for you about asking reviews from Amazon customers. So could you once more explain what are the exact rules Amazon has for sellers to ask reviews from the customers, because Dominic is wondering if it is okay to ask an honest review or not.
Seth, this is your forte.
Yep. So Dominic, what we're referencing there is if you've been in the game for a couple of years, then several years ago, Amazon deemed it okay to ask for a review from your customers that you gave a product to in exchange for an honest, unbiased review. And then they came back later and they said, well, wait a minute, that's not going to work. We're going to ban that as well. So you can't give your product away in exchange for a review. And then that was called an honest, unbiased review, which was obviously biased because you were getting their product for free. So you actually have to provide good value. You can't pay off your customers to give a review, and you can't give them the product that they're going to review. You actually have to provide them a product that they purchased. And then most of the time, Amazon would prefer that you ask for a review through the Amazon ask a review function. So we were kind of alluding to how it used to be with that phrasing. It might've been a little confusing. Hopefully that clears it up.
Thank you very much. And actually I would like to ask to go into more practical information. Let's say, could you give us a few exact tools sellers could use implementing these strategies? I know like we are into email marketing. I could tell a few tools, but what would you recommend? Because some people probably they have never heard these tools and they could start searching.
Sure. So Augustus, I'll just tell you everything that we use when we're building out this for Amazon sellers. So first and foremost, you have to build your list, right? You have to have people come and opt in. So you need something of value. So you need to create what we call a mafia offer, which Shawn walked you through. And then the tool that we use to capture the actual opt-in. So actually, let's back up one more step. So if a customer comes and buys your product, and then they see your product insert that says, hey, watch this important instructional video to make sure that you get the most out of the product. Well, they would see that, see the URL or see the QR code, and then visit your landing page. The landing page, we build those on a platform called ClickFunnels, where then the customer can opt in. It's really simple. It's just like a web page builder. You can do that with WordPress or ClickFunnels, whatever's easiest for you. So then the customer opts in. And then what will happen for us is it'll be integrated with an email service provider. There's all kinds of email service providers out there. You can use Klaviyo or MailChimp. We personally use Aweber, which is a pretty cost-effective service, but it works really, really well for what we're trying to do. So you would have a landing page built on ClickFunnels if you were us, and then the actual email marketing will be done using a tool called Aweber. Hopefully that helps, Augustus.
Yep, Augustus, also all of these tools are mentioned in the book that we're giving away there. So pppro.co/bookfree, they can check it out in there.
And I think we'll should put this link, if it's not there, in the below in the description of this video as well. So let me check another question. How often should I email list if I just want to promote the product I sell on discounted price?
Well, here's the thing where most people get this wrong, Augustus. So we believe that we are our own customer. So I, for one, I do email marketing as a business, but as a consumer, I hate to have unsolicited emails in my inbox. So I don't want anybody to email me, but don't make that mistake, because your fans who are in love with your product, in love with your brand, they want to hear from you. So you really can't send too many. One of our, the busiest campaigns that we have run for about 70 weeks, 70 for one product. And we'll email them at least once per week, and more so around the holidays. The thing is, those who don't want to hear from you will simply unsubscribe. And that's not like getting an F on a report card or a traffic ticket. All they want to do is get off your list, and they're really doing you a favor. So the more you sell, or the more you tell, the more you'll sell. And that's just a fact. So those who do want to learn from you, they'll continue to open and engage in your emails. Those who don't, they'll get off your list, and they're doing you a favor. You don't have to pay to store their name in your email service provider anymore. They're not going to report you as spam. They just simply unsubscribe. That's the beauty of email. So let me ask you, Augustus, how many, well, you're busy right now, so it's, the answer is going to be a little skewed, but how many unread text messages do you have on your phone? Usually none, right? Because we respond immediately. That's an interruption style of marketing. But how many unread emails are in your inbox? Ooh. Probably a few, right? Why? Because email is a more longer form conversational relationship building channel. We open and engage those emails when it's convenient for us. So don't feel like you're talking to your customers too much. We deal with this every day for Amazon sellers, because as a service, we do all this stuff for Amazon sellers, and we work with hundreds of you all over the world. And the biggest pushback we have is, I don't want to annoy my customers. You don't annoy your customers. If you're selling good products that people like to buy, we can always send them, we can't send them enough information. It's entertaining, it's engaging, and you're building authority and brand affinity. It's the best thing you can be doing with that relationship. Great question, Augustus.
Thank you very much for the answer. So we have a couple of more questions for you. So another one is, giving percentage off from the next purchase on the product insert card according to Amazon's TOS. So again, question about the compliance.
Yep. So here's the thing with the TOS compliant card, all we need to do is make sure that we're not trying to manipulate Amazon's review process or circumvent the review process or try to manipulate rankings. If you just simply provide a value and create a situation where the end user of your product drops what they're doing and reaches out to you because you provided so much value, like dignity over here in the question box from pajamas. She says, wow, this is value packed. Can I hire you? Why? Because we provide tremendous value. So if you use that exact same scenario and you provide tremendous value to the end user through your product insert, then the end user, your product, your customer on Amazon is going to love you, and they're going to want to engage and subscribe to you. All right. So if you're doing something stupid with your insert, like trying to build a review list so that you can get fake reviews and try to rank your products through adding to a wish list, then yes, that's against terms of service. But if you just enhance the end user's experience and you make their product and purchase experience better by providing world-class customer support, Amazon loves that. And that's what we do every single day. Great question.
And you talked about creating emails, communicating to your customers. Could you give us some examples of how to create these emails? What language to use? Not to give examples, but where sellers could get more information, maybe someone to follow, some internet marketers they could get inspiration from.
Can I let you know about a podcast?
Yes, of course. It's free, okay, right?
Free podcast. So yeah, actually Seth and I, every Monday on the post-purchase podcast, we publish all of these strategies free, and it's available on any podcast platform that you can find. Spotify, Apple, Google, doesn't matter. So there's one. And then when it comes to the, and those are specific marketing strategies for Amazon sellers. Additionally, I would follow Russell Bunsen's podcast. What's the name of it now, Seth? You rebranded.
I think it's Marketing Secrets.
Marketing Secrets, the Marketing Secrets podcast. And then, of course, the AMPM podcast, now hosted by our friend Kevin King. I think his birthday is this week. So I have to send a shout out to him. Happy birthday, K Square.
And then, Sean, let me just add in a little flavor to that as well. So, Augustus, when somebody's writing an email, I think a lot of times, to touch on what you mentioned earlier, Sean, is that we think that we're projecting this message, and we never think about how the customer's actually feeling. So if you look at like a product insert, which is just like a marketing message, right? A lot of people will put, 10% off your next purchase. And they never think about, well, how would I actually feel if I saw that insert? Well, you're not going to care about 10% off your next purchase when you just had the product show up. So you have to think about, even from the product insert all the way through the emails, like, what would you like to see? What would be really valuable to you if you were your own customer? And then you can get some clues and some hints by reading your product reviews and reading your competitors' product reviews. What are they seeking in their lives? What are they thinking when they just put that product in their hand? Or what would they be thinking when, you know, it's Christmas time and they're looking for a gift? How can you speak to them in a way that, oh, it makes sense? You have to think about it from your customer's perspective and what would be really, really valuable to them. So hopefully that'll help somebody out there.
You know, let me just add to that, Augustus. What you have to think about as a consumer, look at the emails that you're attracted to. Which emails engage you and make you want to open and read? What we're not doing, we're not trying to send newsletters. And I mean, a lot of email marketers, they start out and they send these huge, like they're writing a book, and they expect busy people to stop what they're doing and read that. It's just not going to happen. So we have to be mindful of our customers' time, make it short and to the point, value packed, and then an offer. There always has to end with a call to action. What do you want me to do? You want me to subscribe to your podcast? You want me to join your mailing list? You want me to cash in on a 20% off coupon code? Be friendly, be conversational, be entertaining, be short, and tell me exactly what to do. If you don't, how can you expect me to take action?
Perfect. So what's your call to action after this presentation? How do you want to help Amazon sellers? What do you do? Please let us know more in details.
Steph?
Yeah. So guys, if you want to find out more, like Sean said, we have the podcast, which is free. If you want to learn more about what we do every day, which is help Amazon sellers develop more sales, following up with their customers and having a real relationship with them, then you can just check us out and see what we have going on at postpurchasepro.com. Pretty simple.
So basically, you help with the strategy and you might help with funnels and building, setting up all the systems, right?
Yes, sir. Yeah. We do that as a service, Augustus, and it's there's no harm in booking a call. You can talk to us at postpurchasepro.com/call, C-A-L-L, maybe add that to your show notes, book a call. We'll be more than happy to get on the phone, talk to you about your business, give you some advice. We work with hundreds of sellers all over the world in every single category. So chances are, if you're selling pizza cutters or silicone spatulas, we have a customer who's doing that, so we can give you some really good, solid advice. Not based on theory, rather based on real life experience and historical data.
Perfect. Thank you very much, Sean and Seth. All the relevant links you will find below in the description. And of course, we just implemented last week the feature below our video player, like button. So please click that like button to see if it works. Click once. And thank you very much. Bye bye.
Thank you.
Thank
All
you.
All right. God bless. Bye.
Bye. Oh, bye bye, Lisa. And now I would like to invite you to watch other video where Matt Parker will explain you how to drive external traffic to your Amazon listing using Pinterest. Check this out.